Good afternoon. Really happy to be able to be among these distinguished speakers and to go after Dan, which I think connects with what I'm going to talk about with you today, and that is trust, or at least ideas about what trust is and how it comes about. So we need a definition of trust, and there's many definitions of trust from economics, from sociology, from marketing, and trust is a willingness to be vulnerable. Now, why be vulnerable? Well, vulnerability is based on a set of beliefs or a willingness to believe certain things about the thing in which you are placing your trust. And I think these beliefs are really important, so I'm going to talk about them in a second. So one of the first beliefs we have has to do with the fairness of the thing in which you're putting your trust. So you believe that this thing is going to act justly, that there's not going to be any discrimination related to you or your use or trusting in that thing. We talk about goodness and not necessarily the nutritional value, but we're talking about goodness on the scale of right or wrong. The thing you're placing your trust in falls on the good side, the right side of goodness, right? Related to goodness is benevolence. Now, benevolence is the actual charitable act, the actual doing of the good thing. So we're talking about behavior here that's really important for trust or the belief. And I put strength and ability together because I think they go together. So strength, we're talking about the power to do a thing. And ability, we're talking about the technical know-how to perform the act here. But I think they go together importantly. We also have honesty, that you believe that there's not going to be any deception related to placing your trust in the thing. Please note that the pictures may have nothing to do with what I'm talking about right now. So we also have predictability, and that is that although we can't see all of what the thing is going to do, we can forecast or we can try to predict what's going to happen when we place our trust in that thing, that organization, or that individual. So we're really talking about a relationship. So we have a trustor and we have a trustee. The trustor places the trust. The trustee takes in the trust, right? So it's a relationship. Now, maybe more people in a relationship as well, as you know. Now, relationships can be of two kinds. One kind is a symmetric relationship. So both sides are providing in equal ways. So a symbiotic relationship, both sides mirror imaging each other. But then there's the other kind of relationship, and that's asymmetric. And that is one side has a different level of trust or value being placed in a relationship. Now, this is really important because in an asymmetric relation, one takes more risk or has a higher burden of risk than the other side. So, say if you place your personal information in a system, the burden of risk is on you and not necessarily on the system. In this case. So how do we get in an asymmetric relationship? Persuasion, right? So you persuade a person or a thing to place their trust in you based on aesthetics, other cues, the smile I'm giving you, telling you that what I'm saying is correct, right? But I really want you to act in a certain way. I'm looking for action from you, some kind of behavior that demonstrates you're placing your trust in me as a trustee of whatever it is that you're giving me. And basically, I'm asking you to have a positive outlook or a positive expectation about what it is that I'm going to do for you in this trust relationship. I'm asking you to believe in me in some way, right? Now, really what I'm asking you to do is give me something of value, right? Whether it's data, whether it's money, whether it's kindness, right? I'm asking for something valuable. And that's contextual, right? So the context is really going to matter here. But really, I'm forming a relationship of interdependence. That means I'm going to rely on you for something, whether it's efficiency, for help, whatever the case may be, we're forming some kind of reliance on each other. And this means our relationship is transactional. Now, transactions, people think of as a bad thing, but really it's about the exchange of something for another thing, right? So if we look back in this relationship, when trust breaks down, it is because something is missing in relation to those characteristics regarding trust, honesty, integrity, those kinds of things. Thank you.